Welcome to Audio Video System Playlist. I, Professor Hitesh Dholakia, is going to explain capacitor or condenser microphone in this session. So this session is all about capacitor or condenser microphone. And to explain this, these are my session outlines, where in this session, first I'll be going to discuss basics of condenser or capacitor microphone. Then I'll explain structure of condenser microphone. Then we will see working of condenser microphone. Then after, I'll explain characteristics and features of condenser microphone. And then at the end, I'll sum up this session by explaining applications of condenser microphone. So let us begin this session with first agenda, that is basics of condenser microphone. Now see, to explain this condenser or capacitor microphone, as its name indicates, when capacitance is changing, its output voltage will change. Means based on capacitance, its electrical signal is getting generated. So that is why this microphone is even referred as capacitance or condenser microphone. So how it is getting changed? So for that, basic formula is V is equals to Q by C, where charge in microphone remain constant. And here, when you see the diaphragm movement is happening, there will be change in distance, and distance is depending on capacitance. So capacitance will change, and as capacitance is changing, voltage will change. So change in capacitance will generate electrical signal, and that is how it is working. So see, ultimately, if C will increase, you will be finding there will be decrease in V, as C is inversely proportional to V. And as if C decreases, in that case, you will be finding there will be increase in voltage V, as V is inversely proportional to C. So this is how voltage will change with respect to change in capacitance. So that is what the basic phenomenon which is happening in capacitance or condenser microphone. See, plates are very nearer to each other to form a capacitor, and basically you'll be finding that capacitance C is equals to epsilon 0 epsilon R A by D. So based on diaphragm movement, that D will change, and as if D is changing, you'll be finding capacitance changes, and that capacitance will change that electrical signal V, as per Q is V is equals to Q by C. And fixed DC voltage that has been given to plate to form constant charge Q. So that voltage is about 50 to 100 voltage. Plates are insulated from each other, and that is to generate capacitance in the range of 30 picofarad. So this is what the capacitance that is being generated here by using this condenser microphone. Now let us see the structure of it. So the structure of condenser microphone that one can see here, where this is what diaphragm, and that is connected with spring. So whenever sound pressure that is coming from here, you can see sound wave that is coming from here. So that will apply pressure on this diaphragm, and this diaphragm will move like this. Now here another metal plate is there, and you can see the distance in between diaphragm and metal plate. Now as this diaphragm moves, this distance will change, and as this distance changes, as per capacitance formula, C is equals to epsilon 0 epsilon R A divided by D, where D change will change this capacitance. So as D decreases, C will increase, and as C increases, as D increases, C will decrease. See, that is how it will function. And as we have C, voltage V is equals to Q by C, where Q is constant. If C decreases, V will increase. And if C decreases, in that case, V will increase. And that is how electrical signal will be generated. Here insulator is there, that is to insulate this body and this plate. And from this plate, we are applying constant DC voltage, that you can see it over here, and electrical signal that we can take it from this metal diaphragm, and that will be used to have sound signal as it is directly proportional to the characteristic which is happening with sound signal. So this is how structure is there. And if you see the working, so as we have discussed, diaphragm act as a one plate of capacitor, and other plate is back plate that we have already seen. You can see this is one plate of capacitor diaphragm, and second plate is this metal back plate. Sound pressure moves diaphragm in, and based on that C is increasing. As my diaphragm moves in, distance D will decrease, and if distance D decreases, C will increase, and when diaphragm moves out, D will increase, and as D increases, C will decrease, as C is equals to epsilon 0 epsilon R A by D. So this change in capacitance will change voltage, as voltage V is equals to Q by C. And here this complete structure is functioning based on pressure of sound. So we can say this is what pressure microphone. Now let us discuss characteristics of capacitor microphone or condenser microphone. So when we talk about sensitivity, it is having sensitivity of 3 millivoltage for SPL of 0.1 Pascal pressure. It has SNR which is very high, about 40 dB. So this is very good in terms of signal to noise ratio. It has frequency response ranging from 40 to 15 kilohertz. So see this frequency response, that we can use it for hi-fi system of sound. So for hi-fi system of sound, we can use this microphone, as it is having frequency response ranging from 40 hertz to 15 kilohertz. If you see the distortion, that is less than 1%. So distortion is less than 1%. And frequency response is from 40 hertz to 15 kilohertz. So we can definitely use this in hi-fi sound system. If you see the directivity, it is omnidirectional. So directivity of this capacitor microphone, that is omnidirectional. And if you observe output impedance, then that output impedance is very high. That is about 100 mega ohm. So this is what about characteristic of condenser or capacitor microphone, where sensitivity is 3 millivoltage, signal to noise ratio is very high, about 40 dB, frequency response is from 40 hertz to 15 kilowatts, and distortion is less than 1%. So we can use this system in hi-fi sound system. Its directivity is omnidirectional and has impedance very high, about 100 mega ohm. So this is what about characteristics of capacitor microphone. Now let us see the features. So it is very delicate microphone, so we need to use it carefully. Physically we should use it carefully. It has very high impedance, as we have seen, it is about 100 mega ohm. So extremely high impedance is there with this microphone. It needs external bias supply. So as we have seen, 50 to 100 voltage external bias supply, that has to be given to this microphone. So it needs external bias supply to get function. It cannot withstand with excessive heat from external connection. So this cannot withstand with excessive heat from external connection. So that we need to take care of. And its cost is very high, as we can use this in hi-fi system. It is costly microphone. Now let us see the applications which is there with capacitor or condenser microphone. So the first basic application, that is as standard microphone for calibrating other microphone, we can use this. So for calibration of other microphone, we can use this microphone as a standard microphone. In sound level meter, we can use this. So sound level meter, That is even very important application which is there with capacitor microphone. In professional hi-fi system, we can use this as I have told you, like it has characteristic which is having frequency response from 40 Hz to 15 kHz and distortion less than 1%. So we can use that for hi-fi sound system. So these are the applications which is there with condenser microphone.
Thank you so much for watching this video. I hope that you have understood this session, and I want you to give your valuable suggestions. The reason is I want all those things which is required to be solved here on my channel, and that will be helpful to students, those who are learning from my channel. As well as you will be finding, I have made one application where you can download all this material which I am teaching here free of cost. So you can access it free of cost from my application Engineering Funda. Detail of application that is given in description of all videos. So you can go there, and from there you can download it on your Android mobile phone. So that is how you will be able to understand all those things in parallel with material even. Thank you so much for watching this.